Let us now discuss in this particular session characteristics of tutorial mode of CI. In tutorials, we define objectives. Tutorials are made for specific target group. Tutorials are generally made of small learning chunks. Tutorial is learner-centered. It provides relearning facility to learners. It helps in increasing motivation of learners towards learning. It maintains learners' interest throughout learning sequence. Tutorial helps learners to master the learning skills. And tutorial provides immediate feedback and reinforcement to learners. Major characteristic of any tutorial mode is it presents objectives. So objectives, outcomes are clearly defined for learners. So learners know exactly what they are going to achieve after going through this tutorial mode. And that's why learners get motivated, because they understand that this particular module is important to them in this manner. The other component, or we can say characteristic of tutorial, is tutorial mode is always developed with a specific target group in mind. Here, instructional designers, subject matter experts who develop this particular tutorial mode, they consider needs, abilities, competences, knowledge, skill level of a particular group and accordingly develop that particular tutorial. So they take care of learners' styles of learning. So visuals, videos, animations, activities are also used in tutorial. It depends which target group they are addressing, and language of tutorial mode or that package depends on the target audience. So they consider complexity level depending on audience profile. The other characteristic which is important is tutorial is divided in small learning chunks. So at a time, a very small learning is done through a chunked part. So the entire content is chunked into smaller units. These units are based on logical flow of the content from simple to complex. Those are interrelated, but at the same time, those are separate so as to make learner understand a chunk at a time. They can even revise a particular chunk. It helps to avoid cognitive load on the learner. If you present entire content at a stretch, then it generally gives cognitive load to the learner. At a time, if only small part is learnt and understood, cognitive load is very less for the learner. Because of small chunks and because of freedom for sequence, the package becomes learner-centered. Now here, learner is presented with some chunks and learner has freedom to decide pace and sequence. Though there is a logical sequence already provided, learner has choice to shuffle this sequence as per his or her own choice. Even revisiting that content, revisiting that module is possible when the entire content is provided in chunks. Even there are activities, the entire pace can be managed by the learner, and that's why the entire package is mainly learner controlled. Again, so because this entire package is chunk based, learner can decide his or her own pace of learning. Learner can decide how much time to be spent on a particular module, and even learner has choice to skip some part. For example, if learners is well aware of one type, then that particular type chunk can be skipped by the learner and learner can proceed with the next part. When there is facility of revisiting chunks again and again, mastery can be achieved. So wherever learners have doubt, learner can revisit that module till he or she clears those doubts, and even till entire content is properly understood, learners can go on revisiting. Whenever the learning is based on the pace of learner's speed, mastery can be achieved. So it helps in achieving mastery through the learner. Providing motivation is also a very important characteristic of tutorial mode. Tutorial provides even scores to the learners, feedback to the learners while accessing some assessment or quiz tools. These scores motivate the learner to proceed ahead with the learning sequence. Even it motivates learner to relearn the topic. For example, if the score is only 60%, it will also give feedback to the learner that you have done very well, but it will be better if you go through the package again and revisit this particular test to increase your scores. That motivates learner to reach up to 80%, 90%, and that's why it leads learners towards the mastery. It also motivates learners to participate in other tutorials. For example, after one chunk, if the learner scores mastery and if the learner is guided to visit the other chunk, learner immediately is motivated to open the next chunk. Only motivation doesn't help. If the learner is motivated to visit any chunk, then it's our responsibility to maintain learner's interest also. And we have to maintain learner's interest throughout learning process. In our tutorial mode, we use many graphics, animations, musical examples, audio effects, many videos can be inserted. There can be continuous interactivity where learners are provided with quizzes, games, activities, and that's why it's not mere listening or viewing a particular content, but it is interesting for a learner to achieve some competences through this learning sequence. And because of interesting and motivating nature of tutorial mode, because tutorial provides many questions, provides feedback, provides remediation, provides additional references, mastery of learning skills can be easily achieved. It satisfies all needs of the learner and helps the learner to achieve those skills or competencies. As we are mentioning again and again, tutorial mode provides immediate feedback and reinforcement. And that's why all activities, quizzes, and questions in this particular tutorial package are more meaningful, because learner gets feedback after doing a particular activity, after solving a particular quiz, and it gives more information on the basis of learner's performance to a previous quiz or a previous activity. So it reinforces the learning content. So we have seen various characteristics of tutorial mode, which makes tutorial mode really significant in learning. Thank you.